From Washington, this is VOA News. I'm Christopher Cruz reporting. Four more boys have been brought out of the cave in northern Thailand, where they'd been trapped for more than 2 weeks. A Thai official says they are safe and in the hospital, but four boys and their 25-year-old coach remain in the cave. British Prime Minister Theresa May appointed longtime supporter Jeremy Hunt as foreign minister after Boris Johnson resigned from the post Monday in disagreement with May over the nation's pending exit from the European Union. Johnson complained in his resignation letter that May's plans to maintain close trade ties with the EU amounts to a semi-Brexit, with Britain heading toward the status of colony. Britain's defense minister is blaming Russia for the death of a woman poisoned by the same nerve agent used against an ex-Russian spy and his daughter in March. And a Republican U.S. senator is warning against trusting Russian President Vladimir Putin. Associated Press correspondent Ed Donahue reports.
Louisiana's John Kennedy recently went to Russia with other GOP senators ahead of President Trump's summit next week. He described dealing with the Russian government as like dealing with the mafia, calling Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov a bully and their meetings cantankerous at times. Kennedy called Vladimir Putin a dictator who rules with an iron hand. He added, the Russian people deserve better. Kennedy says they asked about Russian election interference in 2016, and the response was deny, deny, deny. Ed Donahue, Washington.
President Trump on Monday said he has confidence that North Korean leader Kim Jong-un will, quote, honor the contract we signed for the North to denuclearize. This is VOA News. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said during a brief unannounced trip to Kabul, Afghanistan on Monday, that the Trump administration is increasing the pressure for peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban.
They cannot wait us out. And we're beginning to see the results both on the battlefield, where the Taliban's momentum is slowing, and in the prospects for peace with them.
Pompeo met with Afghan President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah. He promised support for Ghani's efforts to open talks with the Taliban. A U.S. government attorney said Monday the government will release about half of the immigrant children under age five who are still in custody. They'll be reunifying them with their families. Associated Press correspondent Shelley Adler reports.
More than 2,000 children have been held in shelters after being separated from their parents at the U.S.-Mexico border. That's under the Trump administration's zero-tolerance policy. A federal judge has ordered the administration to reunify parents with all children under five by tomorrow. A government attorney says authorities will release 50 children. That's about half of the kids under age five who are still in custody. Shelley Adler, Washington.
Automaker BMW is raising prices on the SUVs it builds in the United States and sells in China because of higher tariffs. Associated Press correspondent Mike Hempen reports.
China is raising the import tax on cars from the U.S. to 40% in retaliation for higher tariffs imposed on Chinese goods by President Trump. The DPA news agency reports the Munich-based company says it's not in position to, quote, completely absorb the tariff increases, unquote. BMW builds SUV models in Spartanburg, South Carolina, where it employs 10,000 people. Those vehicles are exported to 140 countries, making BMW the largest U.S. auto exporter. I'm Mike Hempen.
A judge in Myanmar ruled Monday that two journalists for the Reuters news agency must face trial for allegedly breaking the country's secrecy laws by reporting on the Rohingya crisis. The ruling comes after months of preliminary hearings. The two are accused of breaching the Official Secrets Act, which carries a maximum penalty of 14 years in prison. Reuters called the court proceedings protracted and baseless. It said the reporters, quote, were doing their jobs in an independent and impartial way, and there are no facts or evidence to suggest that they've done anything wrong or that they've broken any law. You can find more on these and other late-breaking and developing stories from around the world, around the clock, at voanews.com and on the VOA News mobile app. I'm Christopher Cruz, VOA News.
That's the latest world news from VOA.